Welcome to China Horse Business, the one and only podcast focusing on the booming horse market in China, bringing to you by two experts of Chinese equine industry, Zoe King and Jojo Wang from Shanghai and Hong Kong, introducing China to the world.
Morning, Zoe. We are doing great. As the fifth wave of the pandemic is easing, the daily life and economic activities are returning to normal, big competition restarted, and the Hong Kong Tourism Board announced the city is now reopening for the overseas travelers.
What a great news. I think many cannot wait to come to Hong Kong for food and travel again.
Yes, and how is Shanghai doing?
Same here. Things are getting better. The confirmed cases have been decreasing in the last 3 weeks. And the Shanghai government predicts the city should release the social restriction on May 24 and the latest June.
Sounds excellent, Zoe. As the horse welfare awareness is increasing in China, the Shanghai Equestrian Association acts as the strongest backup for the equine community to assure all stable in the region have sufficient feed, hay and bedding supply for all the horses under the pandemic.
This app helps especially small stables in the city. And coming to our China news today, I think many of our listeners may already know the 19th Asian Games in Hangzhou 2022 has been postponed due to the pandemic. And it is predicted that Asian Games will be postponed the second half year of 2023.
Yes, Zoe, the postponement of the game is no doubt increasing the cost of the Asian game in total and disturbing athletes and their horses' training program. But one of the good things is, if the game is happening next year, there will be a much bigger chance that the game will open to the public to participate. And this is a good news for all equestrian fans.
Sure, Jojo, and one of the most important things that many people were concerned about was the disease-free zone of the equine facility. Because OIE only approved the disease-free zone for the Asian Games as a temporary venue up to December in 2022.
Yes, and Mr. Yue, the Secretary General of the China Horse Industry Association, mentioned, referring to the delay of the Tokyo Olympic, which also been postponed, it might provide us with a clear view. If the Asian Games postponement exceeds the final validity of the grounded time frame this year, Tonglu disease-free zone will need to declare again with OIE, which means to go through the procedure again, and this should not be a big challenge.
We will keep our listeners most up-to-date information on the Asian Games, so please stick with us. Coming to the China Cup session today, we are going to bring you to the Pegasus Equestrian Development Company Limited.
The club is located in Punyu District in Guangdong, covering an area of 13 acres. This includes riding trails, indoor and outdoor arenas, which will facilitate different competitions.
Not only that, they currently have over 110 stables and facilitated with a coffee shop, whiskey and cigar bar, wine tasting area, restaurant, and over 50 guest rooms.
What is unique about the club is that they adopt the Sweden equestrian riding system and employed coaches from Sweden to coach the riders and issued certificates. And to ensure the quality of the education, all horses used in the program were imported from Europe.
And we mentioned in our previous episode that more riding clubs are taking up social responsibility. In 2016, Pegasus started providing riding-assisted therapy to over 500 children with autism spectrum.
Pegasus also developed a low-carbon stable management system, which is a 3-in-1 stable management system. An internet management terminal, plus environmental intelligent technology stable, plus Swedish stable management system. The club aims to promote this system in China.
It is exciting to see a new business model popping up in the industry. All right, Jojo, who do we have in our China story section today?
Yes, and today we have invited a guest from France. Let's listen to Guillaume Marcotte's story.
Hello, Guillaume. How are you doing?
I'm good, thank you.
Yeah, I know you are.
I'm very good, thank you. Could you please tell us a little bit who you are, what you are doing, what's your activities?
I'm Guillaume Marcotte. I'm doing with OSIS since around 20 years. I'm mostly a consultant, coach, rider, and I sell also OSIS. Like, for example, as a coach, I got students who went to the Asian Games, also Olympics in eventing. I got also some French rider who went to the Junior European Championship. As a rider, I produce OSIS till CSI 3 star, that's around 150 level, and I sold them after. As a seller, I sold horses who compete up to 5 star, then the biggest competition in the world. Yeah, that's what I'm doing.
Great. So could you tell us a little bit more about your China experience?
Okay, in 2010, I saw like a reportage about China. And yeah, because of that, I say, oh, why not? I would like to discover what is happening in China. And then I planned some travel to Shanghai and Beijing. And I met a lot of people. I realized the market was really growing at that time because 2 years before was 2008 Olympics. I really realized China is a market who grow really fast. Then I came a few times and yeah. Each time it was all to sell horses or to give some clinic. Like I went also to Jinan with the help of my friend Melody Bigot. She's a French trainer who was working there. Yeah, I met also Jojo. It was interesting to see the market there.
I know you have been to China a few times, visiting the stables and talking with different people. What is your impression towards them?
I was really surprised of the quality of some stables. Of course, some of them are only normal and some of them are amazing. The ground also was high quality. Of course, in competition, sometimes the public is not there, it's not enough people watching the show. But you can see the Chinese are really in a way to be really professional. And they make all the budget to get some good vets, good farrier, and they really want to be professional.
Because you have been to all these places now, and I know you are also scheduling some clinics in Hong Kong and mainland. So, what do you think the China equestrian market have to improve the most?
Of course, at the moment, as you know, it's difficult with COVID because it's now more than 2 years we are not able to come to China or it's complicated to do it. But I think the market is growing quite fast. Of course, everything can be faster, better, but I believe it's going in the right way. Now, what can be done is maybe to have even more riders who ride at the biggest level. And for that, I think Chinese investors should start to invest on young horses. Around 6, 7 years old, maybe keep them a little bit more in Europe because in China at the moment, I think you don't have really a course for young horses, and in Europe it's quite developed. And when they are older, then they can come to China or they can stay in Europe to compete with Chinese riders. Because as what I see, you have really a lot of riding school coming up. You are already investing a lot on ponies, on horses for young people. And that's really good, but okay, you need always to dream, and these small kids, they want to dream to be the best rider later on. And if you have more riders who jump in a bigger level, I think it will help to grow even more the market.
Yeah, thank you very much. It was nice to talk to you.
Thank you.
I hope to see him soon again once the mainland border is reopened.
Yes, and guys, please subscribe and like our podcast if you find information is helpful. And feel free to write to us at contact@wonder-horse.com if you would like to know more about China's equine market.
Right, let's wrap up here today and talk to you next week.
Bye.
This podcast is co-hosting by Zoe King and Jojo Wang. Powered by Wonder Horse, a business solution provider focusing on Chinese equine market and a bespoke equine community in China.